How is it going, everyone? Welcome to my channel. I am Daksh and I am here to talk about TDD, Test Driven Development, which is a part of eXtreme programming practices. Now, no matter which programming language you use for development, TDD is for each and every programming language. It's a programming practice and it does help you in improving the quality of your code. So hang on with me till the end. Now, if you know TDD, still hang on with me because your perception of TDD is gonna change after this video. Now, before I go ahead and start, just a reminder, if you like my contents, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, okay? So let's go ahead and start looking into TDD. Let's first define TDD. Here is my definition of TDD. TDD is a way of writing code where unit test code for testing the production code is written in advance. So we all know that for testing the code, developers write unit tests. What TDD is all about is that unit test code for testing the production code is written in advance. That is before writing the production code. That's about definition first. Now, there is a general consensus about TDD. If you maybe create a internet poll or talk to people or talk to experts, talk to big name in programming like Martin Fowler or Uncle Bob Martin, you know, there is a consensus that TDD is better if it is used. Even people like us knows that TDD is better if it is used. Now, even with this consensus, there is a problem. Why don't everyone using it? That's a big question to answer, isn't it? And I am going to answer that question by the end of this video. So we will gonna talk about this, but let's first understand what is TDD. TDD is a four-step process. It is also called red-green refactor. Now the red part is, which is step one, it talks about writing enough failing test without writing any production code. Now the term enough is subjective over here. It depends upon individual developers. What is the meaning of enough? Couple of lines of code, one function, two function, 100 function. It depends totally upon the individual developer, their expertise and experience level with the TDD. Once you completed step one, you go to step two, which is all about writing just enough production code to pass the failing test which you have written in step one. That is step two, and which is called green step. Step three is refactor the code if required. So when you start writing TDD, most likely you are going to skip step three for some time. But if you have a big code base, you will end up refactoring the code every time you write new set of test cases. And that is going to happen more often than not. And step four is go back to step one and repeat the cycle. So TDD is these four step process, red, green, refactor, write enough, enough is subjective, failing test cases. Step two, write production code to pass those failing test cases. Step three, refactor the code if required. It will be required if you are changing code which is already big, okay, more often than not. Now, this is what TDD is. This is what red, green, refactor is. Now, when people define TDD, they stop at this place. And I am not gonna do so, okay? Because this is just the beginning of TDD. It is not TDD yet, okay? So let's see a demo first. So for example, I want to create a test-driven development for a sum function, right? Which takes two value and returns me the sum of these two values, okay? So as a step one, what I will do is that I will first write the test cases. Here is how I am going to write my test cases. I will write a test case called test sum and I will pass 10, 20. If result is equal to 30, that means test is passed. Otherwise, test is failed. Makes sense? Now, if I have written this test case and start running the code, this function will fail because there is no sum function available. So I will go to step two. I will define a sum function and I will do return a plus b, okay? And Step 3 is not very obvious over here, but I can go to step 3 and do a refactoring of the code, saying that, you know, I should check the type of A and B, that both are int. Okay, this is a crude code just for explanation purpose. So this is the step 3, which is refactor. Step 1, writing the test sum function. Step 2, writing the production sum function. Step 3, refactoring, where I am verifying that type of A and B is actually integer or floating point type, so that you can actually sum those numbers. Okay, so this is a demo of TDD. This is how you write TDD code. Okay, makes sense? Now, till here it was simpler. Now let's go ahead and see something more. So this example is okay, right? All of you have gone through this example and you understood how the TDD is written for a sum function, right? It is very simple for smaller functions like this, but there is a problem. What is the problem? You cannot write tests out of thin air. This is one thing which nobody talks when they talk about TDD. You cannot go ahead and start writing tests, okay? Just like you need a car to do a test drive and you need a product in your hand to experience it, you need something before writing the test cases. You cannot write tests in thin air, and this is the place most of the developers stop writing TDD, because they are being told to write test first as a religious activity. Okay, they have to write test first, and you cannot write tests out of thin air. You need something. So this is where people not only misunderstood TDD, but also explaining it to others in a totally wrong way. They say that go ahead and write test first. Okay, it's very easy to write test for the sum function. But think about it. When I am writing the test function, how do I know that the sum function name is sum? It could be add, right? Or it could be sum of two numbers. How do I know the name of the function? Got the point? We are going to explore these points in more detail. Now let's talk about what we have discussed. We cannot write tests out of thin air. Okay. As an example, we talked about what is the name of the function you are testing. For example, in case of sum function, what are the classes you will be using in your functions? For example, sum function might not just be a function, it might be function inside a class. And you need to know the name of the class before calling the sum function, or you even may need to instantiate the class to create an object before calling this function. What are the name of the interfaces you are planning to do? These things are required before you can go ahead and start writing tests first. Now, all of you understood that these are valid questions, right? Now, let me give you the answer of these questions. It's perfectly okay to write a skeleton code before writing any test in TDD. Yes, I am telling in terms of TDD, where people say you have to write test first. Yes, but I will come to that test in a moment. What I am saying that even if you are using TDD, it's perfectly okay to write a skeleton code before writing any tests. Okay. For example, let's talk about if I am creating a calculator. It's perfectly okay to come up with this particular class. Okay. Class calculator. Define empty functions like add, sub, mul. Okay. It's perfectly okay. We can write this class, this skeleton class, before writing any tests. Okay, I am talking about TDD. Yes, TDD, where you need to write test first, but you can write a skeleton code so that you know what is the functions you are trying to call, what is the class you are trying to call, where the function is located, which you want to test. Okay, now what TDD says that you have to write test first, but what are you testing? You are testing the functionality, you are testing the implementation. So what TDD is saying that write the test before implementing any of these functions or functionality. Before that, these skeletons are dummy and of no use. That's the reason you can create skeletons in TDD and then write tests before writing any implementation. So Instead of going to add and writing return A plus B or sub writing returning A minus B or in mul writing return A into B, what you have to do is that write test for add, sub, mul first before writing it. And remember from step one, what I said, that write enough test cases, enough failing test cases, okay? For some developer, they may want to write test cases for add and then implement add. Some developers may want to write all the test cases for add, sub and mul, then they want to start implementing it one by one. It's totally depends upon individual. The idea of unit test is you have to write test first for the implementation, for the functionality. Okay, are you getting my point? Because these things nobody tells while talking about TDD or while teaching about TDD. Now, when we write unit test cases, there are something that comes to our mind. You know, we should write positive test cases, we should write negative test cases. Let me clarify one more thing. There is no concept of positive and negative test cases in TDD. Yes, there is no concept of positive and negative test cases. You write tests for whatever you are implementing. Let's see one example. So this is the same test, some example, you know, result calling some function 10, 20. If result is 30, test is passed. And here is how I am writing my sum function, like, you know, it just returns A plus B. Now I want to make sure that if there is anything other than integer comes in my function, I will not accept that. So what I will do is that I will first write a failing test, test sum 2, and I am passing hello world. If the result is hello world, test fail, because it is actually adding 2 string, which is not supposed to be the functionality of this particular sum function. Otherwise, test is passed, okay? And then I go ahead and change the implementation by checking the type, returning A plus B, otherwise returning 0, right? So you are actually writing test for whatever you are implementing. You are not writing any negative test cases. You are writing test cases for whatever implementation you are doing. The idea of positive and negative test cases come when you give this function to someone else who is not writing the development code, and they want to test it in a different scenarios, right? When you are doing TDD, you are writing test for implementing that. Whether you are implementing a happy path, whether you are implementing exception is raised or not, or return minus one is happening, or return error is happening or not. All those things you are writing test cases for, and then you are implementing them. So they are not about positive and negative test cases. They are about implementation of things, right? So if you write so-called negative test case, you end up implementing. So in TDD, nothing known as positive and negative test cases. Because you know what? If the test fail, you don't give the code back to a developer saying that, you know, just fix it. It is you, the developer, who is writing the unit test cases in case of TDD, and there is no positive and negative test cases. You think about various aspects to make sure that you are implementing that. Okay? So that's all about TDD. I hope and believe that I have explained the concepts of TDD in the best possible way. And I also believe that I clarified many of the misconceptions about TDD, like, you know, test first. Okay, so that's all for this particular video. Thanks a lot, people. Thanks for watching. Till the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.